Why do events like Raindance that celebrate independent storytelling matter so much?
Because it's precisely that. They celebrate independent film filmmaking and storytelling. They're films that have so much more freedom, and they often tell stories that otherwise would get overlooked, or they're not kind of sexy enough, and they're stories that really matter. And Raindance makes it its mission to focus on those stories. So it's, without Raindance, a lot of films and stories wouldn't be told.
In terms of great stories, what are the stories that we're going to see you in next? What have you got coming up yourself at the moment?
What have I got coming up? I mean, there's things that I've already filmed that will be coming out next year, but I don't think I'm allowed to talk about them. I'm just going to have to...
Films, TV shows, what kind of things?
One is a film and two are TV shows. All comedies, because I'm hilarious.
Apparently. And you can't tell us anything about any of them, what they're called even?
There's one that's with Mae Martin, who's the Canadian comedian. It's kind of her new show. They've just changed the name of it, so I'm really not being very helpful. But I'm not very helpful. But I think that's going to be on Channel 4 and Netflix.
As everything is these days. You mentioned working with Mae. Why do you think it's such an exciting time, particularly for female comedians? Because it's traditionally been such a male-dominated space, but it seems to almost be reversing at the moment.
I think it's just... that ridiculous trope of women not being funny. I mean, even the phrase female comedians is really annoying. It's like female director, female writer. I think we're slowly edging towards a point where you won't need the pronoun.